Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to another session of Data Structures and Algorithms. My name is Dr. Bilal Wajid, and today we're going to continue on the functions which correspond to a linked list. Today we're going to talk about traverse. Now, we already talked about in lecture 24 of the function create. Today we're going to talk about traverse. Now, before we proceed, how do we program a single component? You can actually do that using a structure. So a structure allows you to have multiple, you know, variables defined within it. We need a variable which could be value, name, marks, but we especially need this pointer by the name of next, which can point to another element. That actually helps us point from one element to point to another element. And that is actually fundamental to our linked list definition. Now, how do we combine multiple elements? Here we have an element pointer A. So A is a pointer that can point to an element, right? A has been assigned as new element, allocates within the memory location a size which is needed for our structure element, and then we've just initialized. So right now, the pointer which A is pointing to has been assigned to null. So it's pointing to a zero location, a null location. The same goes for B. Now, how do we connect these two? It's actually fairly easy. You just simply say that A's next has been assigned, you know, B, and B's next has been assigned as null. So A's next points to B, and B's next points to, let's say, C, and C's next points to D, and D's next points to null. So that way you can combine multiple elements. Now, there are two global variables that we need that really simplifies our programming significantly. The first is length. So this making integer length equal to zero makes it visible to every function. So if you want to add elements, you need to increment length. When you want to delete elements, you can decrease length accordingly. And the other extremely important global variable is start, because it is this pointer start that points to our linked list. Hence, you know, making it a global variable makes it really, really convenient. Now, the traverse function has two elements or two things you need to think about. The first is, how do you traverse a linked list when the linked list is empty? And then how do you traverse a linked list when it is not empty? So there are really two options you need to program. The first is, how do you traverse when the list is empty? Well, you don't, right? So if the length is equal to zero, right? Our length is a global variable. So if length is equal to zero, you can simply print the list is empty and then just exit. But what happens if the list is filled? Well, it's the else condition which now is invoked, right? So the first thing you do is, when you want to traverse a linked list, you create a pointer A. Right, so element pointer A, and then A has been initialized to start. In other words, A now points to the first element of our linked list. In fact, both start and A point to our first element of the linked list. Now, we need to do this because we want a separate pointer to point to the linked list. We don't want to update start. Start will always, by definition, you can call it beginning if you want to, will always point to the first element of the linked list, right? So now that we have A, right, let's look at our while loop. So you're going to continue up until you reach null. In other words, as long as A's next is not null, you can continue. So what do you do in when that is holds true, because A's next is another element, right? So you print the value. So here you've deliberately see that value 1 has been printed in red, right? So value 1 gets printed. And then after value 1 is printed, A has been assigned as A's next. So A is no more pointing to this element. Actually, A is now pointing to the next element, right? Again, because A's next is not equal to null, right? You go back, you check the condition, it's true. You then print the value which is stored in this element, right? You can notice here that value 2 has been marked red. And then again, you obviously update A, so A is now pointing to the next element, right? So now you go back again to the while loop and check, is next not equal to null? No, that's not true, because is next is equal to null, right? So you end the while loop and you come outside. Notice as you finish the while loop and you come outside, you haven't really printed value 3, right? Otherwise, this would have been shown as red. So you've printed all the elements that came before, the values within those elements, you've already printed those, but you haven't printed the value of the last element. So once you exit the while loop, you do need a statement here, right? And this actually helps you print the value 3, which now is shown in red. Now you can actually print it, okay? So this actually gives us the entire function again, you know, which considers both what to do when the list is empty and when the list is filled. I would strongly recommend you actually try these codes before moving to the next lecture. If you like my lecture, please hit the thumbs up button, subscribe and hit the bell icon so you get updated for new videos as they are placed. Okay, up until next time, thank you very much. Bye-bye.